Let us start exercise 2.4.
Dear students, let us start our exercise number 2.4. What problem? In this particular exercise, we will have the value of variable on both the side of equation as what we did in our previous exercise. But only the difference is in previous exercise, the equation were given. But in this particular exercise, statement given, from that we have to form equation and then we need to find the value of variable. Now let us start our first sum. Question number 1. Aminas think of a number and subtract 5 by 2 from it. C multiplies the result by 8. The result now obtained is 3 times the same number she thought of. What is the number? Now dear student, as I told you, there are variable on both sides of equation. So let us divide it into two parts. Amina think of a number and subtract 5 by 2 from it. C multiplies the result by 8. Till here, let us consider in the first part. Try to solve our first part. Now Amina think of a number. We don't know what the number is. So let us suppose it. Let the number Amina think of bx. Now and subtract 5 by 2 from it. C subtracted 5 by 2 from it. So let us subtract 5 by 2 from x equals to x minus 5 by 2. Then C multiply the result by 8. Whatever result we got, C used to multiply it by 8. So multiplying result by 8 gives whatever result we used to have, so used to multiply it with 8. Now our first part over. Now try to solve it. Multiply the result with 8. So 8 into x gives 8x. Then 8 5s are 40. 40 divides by 2, divide by 2 gives 20. Now dear student, the result now obtained, whatever the result we got over here, the result now obtained is 3 times the same number. Same number means the number what she thought of. Now whatever the result obtained, so as per the condition, the result whatever is obtained is 3 times the same number she thought of. In the beginning she think of a number. She think of a number and we considered it as a x. So the result obtained is 3 times the number she thought of, and that number is x. See, here we got our equation. Now from here we need to solve and try to get the value of x. Let us do it over here. 8x minus 20 equals to 3x. Now dear student, from here you know how to solve the equation. Follow same step, transposition. Try to bring 3x toward your left. While bringing, that positive 3x will become negative, and try to take this 20 toward your right. So negative 20 will become positive. So write it over here, transposing transposing 3x to LHS and negative 20 to RHS. Now by doing such, you will get 8x minus 3x give 5x and here 20. Now try to eliminate this 5. What you will do? It is in multiple form. So what I will do? I will try to divide this 5x by 5. Whatever value I am taking toward my left, same value you have to take toward your right. So by doing such, 5 and 5 will get cancelled. So 5 and 20 divides 5 gives 4. Now, that means the final question, what is the number? So the number is 4. Amina think of a number 4. So therefore, the number is 4. Let's see question number 2. a positive number is 5 times another number. If 21 is added to both the numbers, then one of the new numbers become twice the other new number. What are the numbers? Now, how to do such? Now, let us first suppose the another number px. See here, because a positive number is 5 times the another number. One positive number is there, which is 5 times the another number. So, let us suppose first, let the other number be x. Therefore, positive number is 5 times the another number. Therefore, the positive number equals to 5 times the another number means 5 times of x. Now, if 21 is added to both the numbers, means we have to add 21 to both the number, that is the other number and the positive number. Adding 21 to both the numbers gives x plus 21 and 5x plus 21. Now, dear student, our first part over. Now, from here, second part start. Then, one of the numbers become twice the new number. Now, dear student, one of the new number. These are our two new number. Now, out of both, one number is twice the other. So, you can take any. Now, first new number is x plus 21 and second is 5x plus 21. It seemed greater. So, what I will do, as per the condition given, one of the new number, that is, let us take this. We will take this one. You can take this also. One of the new number becomes twice the other new number. It becomes twice. Twice means two times the other new number. Other new number means this one. This is how we got our equation. Now try to resolve this bracket. Therefore, 5x plus 21, 2 into x, 2x plus 2, 21s are 42. Now from here you can solve the equation and find the value of variable x. Let us solve it over here. Write down the value 5x plus 21 equals to 2x plus 42. Now here what we will do? Same rules, same method. Transposing. Now what I will do? I will try to transpose this 2x toward my left. And whatever is left, write down as it is. And try to transpose this 21 toward your right. Write it over here. Transposing 2x to LHS and positive 21 to RHS. By doing such, now it will be easier for you to do subtraction. 5x minus 2x give 3x. 42 minus 21. 21 is exactly half of 42. That is 21 only. Now, dear student, try to eliminate this 3. What I will do? I will try to divide this 3x by 3 so that 3 will get cancelled. Whatever value I have taken on my left, same value you have to take on your right. Write on over here, dividing both the sides by 3. So that 3 and 3 will get cancelled. X. 21 divided by 3 gives 7. Now, that means, what are the number? They are talking about what are number. So, therefore, the other number, which is equals to X, which is equals to 7. and the positive number and which is 5 times the other number, that is 5x, 5 into 7, that means the numbers are 7 and 35. Therefore, the numbers are 7 and 35. Let us start our sum number third. Sum of the digit of a two-digit number is 9. When we interchange the digit, it is found that the resulting new number is greater than the original number by 27. What is the two-digit number? Now, dear student, such kind of sum means sum of digit of a two-digit number is 9. Such kind of sum is very much important. Not only for this year, in future also, in standard 9th and 10th also such kind of sum will come. So, better pay attention properly and try to understand what I am doing. Dear students, sum of digits of two-digit number. First of all, you have to understand what are the digits of a two-digit number. Let me explain you with some example. Take for example, if I am writing 45, or you can take any number 36, sum of both number means this is a two-digit number. Now, it is divided into two parts, that is 10s and 1. You know such thing. In lower classes, you did such kind of expansion. Now, if this is just an example, I had taken 45, you can take 36 or 7 plus 2, that also 9, you can take 72 or 27. Now, these are the digits of two-digit number. These are, that is 4 and 5 are the digits of two-digit number. Now, further if you say that 4 is what? How to get 45? 4 is a multiple of 10 plus 5 is a multiple of 1. 4 times are 40. 40 plus 5 gives 45. This is our original number. Now, dear student, in this question, sum of the digit of two-digit number is 9. Now, the sum of, we don't know both the digits. Both the digits are missing. This is just an example I had shown you. So, if we'll suppose our unit digit, that is 1's digit, bx, if digit at 1's place, or you can write if unit digit be x. Therefore, if you take your unit digit be x, so what will be the digit at 10's place? Therefore, the digits at 10's place. If the sum of two digits, sum of two digits is 9, it is given 9. Therefore, the digit at 10 place. If unit digit is x, so that means the digit at 10 place will be 9 minus x. Don't think of this number. This is just an example. This is just to make you understand what are unit digit and what are 10 digit. So now, digits at 10 place is 9 minus x. Now, dear student, we need to find its original value. So, original number will be what? As I told you, 10 times of 10 digit number, here the 10 digit number is 9 minus x plus 1 time unit digit number, your unit digit value is x. So 10, 9's are 90, 10 into x, 10x, 9 in, 1 into x is x. That means 90, 10x minus 10x and plus 10x gives minus 9x. This is your original number. Yes, so then we don't have a number. That is why they had asked, we need to find the two digit number. Both the digit we need to find. This is just an example. Now, dear student, when we interchange the digit, it is found that the resulting new number is greater than the original number. Now, we have to interchange the digit. So, interchanging the digit. Means what? The new number will be. Interchanging the digit means what? Whatever the value in ones place will go in tens place. Say for example, that is whatever the value in unit place will go in tens place, and whatever the value in tens place will go in unit place. The sum of both will be the same only. So here also, now 10 times, now previously we had multiplied 10 with whatever the value in 10 place. Now you have to multiply here in U, after interchanging the digit, now 10 will be multiplied whatever the value in unit place. You have to interchange, and plus 1 multiplied by whatever the value in 10 place, that is 9 minus x. Now you have to think that whatever the value previously in unit place will go in 10 place, and whatever the value in 10 place will go in unit place. Very simple, just interchange the digit. Now it will give 10x, and 1 multiply with 9 gives 9, 1 multiply with x gives minus x. Now 10x minus x is 9x and 9. Now dear student, it is asked that when interchanging the digit, we interchange the digit, whatever it is found that the resulting new number, now this resulting new number is greater than the original number by 27. So now there is no need of such. As per the condition, what is said over here, the resulting new number, is greater than original number by 27. This new number is greater than original number. Our original number is this, is greater than original number by 27. So add 27 to it. Means whatever the new number, means this we are talking about, that is 9x plus 9, this value is greater than original number by 27. The original number is 90 minus 9x. Add 27 to it. Why? Because new number is greater than original number by 27. So 27 more than original number. Now same method, transposition. What you need to do is try to bring this negative 9x toward your left hand side. The negative will become positive, and write on this 90 as it is, 27 as it is, and try to take this constant value 9 toward your right, so it will become negative. So in statement what you will write, transposing negative 9x to LHS and 9 to RHS. By doing such, now you can easily add the value, that is 9x plus 9x gives 18x. Now 90 plus 27 minus 9. So 90 minus 9 is 81, and add 81 to 27 gives 108. Now dear student, we need to eliminate this value of 18. So what I will do, I will divide both the side by 18, as I told you previously also, so that 18 and 18 will get cancelled. So I am now dividing both these sides by 18. By doing such, 18 and 18 will get cancelled. Now divide it. As you all know that 18 what? Divide it over here. Not possible, 0. 18, 6 I think. So 18, 6 are multiplied over here. 8, 6 are 48, 4 carry and 10. So 18, 6 are 108. Now dear student, we got the value of x, that is 6. Now what we will do, we will try to find a unit digit first. Therefore, unit digit equals to x equals to 6, tens digit, that is 9 minus x gives 9 minus 6 equals to 3. Now dear student, here they had asked what is the 2 digit. So we got our both the digit, that is unit place 6 and 10 place 3. So our original number which is 90 minus 9 times x, 90 minus value of x is 6, 9 minus 9, 6 are 54, and we used to get 90 minus 54 is 36. That means our original number is 36. When we will add, that is unit, see, we check the value, unit place 6 we got and tens place 3 we got. When you add both the value, that is 3 plus 6, that is sum of digits of 2 digit number is 9. We verify the question also. Let us see sum number 4. One of the 2 digits of a 2 digit number is 3 times the other digit. If you interchange the digit of this 2 digit number and add the resulting number to the original number, you get 88. What is the original number? Now dear student, nothing to worry. It is exactly similar to our previous sum. First of all, if you don't know what a 2 digit number, I will explain with you an example with a number. Suppose 26 is your 2 digit number. Means here, see, according to the condition I had taken the example, one of the 2 digit of a 2 digit number is 3 times the other digit. Here, one value is 3 times the other value. This is your 10 digit and this is your unit digit. Here unit digit is 3 times the 10 digit, means 6 is 3 times the 2, 2 3 are 6, or you can write 62, or you can write 31, or you can write 13, but it should be, one number should be 3 times the another. We don't know that number, we need to find those number. Now let us start. Now first let the unit digit be x. If we suppose our unit digit be x, what will be our 10 digit? As according to this condition, the 10 digit, any one of the 2 digit is 3 times the other. If our 1 digit is x, we don't know. So our, therefore, the 10 digit number, 10 digit be 3 times the unit digit, that is 3x. Now here, we have to find compulsory, in such kind of sum, you need to find your original number. So original number. How to find the original number? It should always be multiple of 10 times the 10 digit number plus 1 time the unit digit number. 10 times the 10 digit number. Here the 10 digit number is 3x. And the unit digit number is x. So 10, 3 is a 30x, 1 into x is x, 1x means x only. So 30x plus x gives 31x. Now we got our original value, original number. Now dear student, if you interchange the digit of this 2 digit number, now you need to interchange the digit. So first interchange the digit. Interchanging the digit means, interchanging the digit means will not give different number. Means interchanging the digit means the result will be same. Means 30 means 1 and 3 and or 31. Sum of both are always same. 2 plus 6 or 6 plus 2. The sum are always same. So interchanging the digit. So while interchanging the digit, whatever the new number. You have to find the new number. Whatever the new number will be. Again, how to find the number? 10 time of 10 digit and 1 time of unit digit. Now previously, your unit digit was x. Now you have to take 3x. And previously your 10 digit was 3x. Now you have to take x. You have to interchange the digit. Now 10 digit will be your x, not this. Because the digits are interchanged. So now previously you have taken 3x, so here you have to take x. And in one digit previously you have taken x, so you have to take 3x. Now 10 into x gives 10x plus 1 into 3x gives 3x. While adding, you will get 13x. Now, dear student, if you interchange the digit, you already did, of this two digit number, and add the resulting number to the original number. This is our resulting number. We need to add this value with the original number. So we will get 88. So as per the condition, after interchanging whatever the resulting number, this is our resulting number. Resulting number to the original number. What we need to add? Add the resulting number to the original number. So we need to add this value to the original number. So 13 plus 13x plus 31x. Or you can write 31x first, then add 13x to it. Gives 88. Now sum of both 13 plus 31x gives 44x. Now, dear student, very easy. Try to eliminate this 44. So what I will do? I will divide this 44x by 44. So whatever value I'm taking over here, same value you have to take toward your right. So that 44 and 44 will get cancelled. And what you will write in statement? Dividing both these sides by 44. Now here I'm getting x. Now 44 twos are. The value of x I got 2. Now dear student, try to find both the digit. First try to find therefore unit digit which is equal to x, which is equal to 2. 10 digit, which is 3 times the unit digit, that is 3 times the x, that is 6. That is, we got our both the digit. Now find the original number. Original number equals to 31 times x, and value of x we got 2. So 31 twos are 62. We got our original number, that is 62. See, the condition also satisfied. And one digit is 3 times the another digit, and 2 is, and 6 is 3 times the 2. Let us do sum number 5. Saroj's mother present age is 6 times Saroj's present age. Saroj's age 5 years from now will be 1/3 of his mother's present age. What are their present ages? Now here condition for Saroj's mother age is given. Saroj's mother's present age is 6 times Saroj's present age. So let us suppose Saroj's present age be x. Let Saroj's present age be x. If Saroj's present age is x, then his mother's present age will be 6 times Saroj's present age. So therefore, Saroj's mother present age will be 6 times Saroj's present age, that is 6x. Now dear student, Saroj's age 5 years from now will be 1/3 of his mother's present age. So we need to find Saroj's age after 5 years. So after 5 years, Saroj will be, if Saroj's present age is x, after 5 years, Saroj will be x plus 5. And if Saroj's mother's present age is 6x, so Saroj's mother will be 6x plus 5. Now, dear student, condition is given that Saroj's age 5 years from now, that is x plus 5, will be 1/3 of his mother's present age. So after 5 years, Saroj will be 1/3 of his mother's present age. So as per the condition, Saroj's age 5 years from now, that is x plus 5, will be 1/3. So you have to do 1/3 of his mother's present age. So Saroj mother present age is 6x. So you have to do 1/3 of 6x. Suppose if this present age is not mentioned over here, so you have to find, you have to do 1/3 of this one. Now dear student, from here it is very simple for you. Write on as it is. Now if cancellation is possible, you can do cancellation. 3 2s are, so 2x we got over here. Now very simple, therefore x plus 5 equals to 2x. So what we will do, so just interchange it. Now it seems easier for you to do transposition. Bring your x toward your left, whatever is left, write down as it is. Write down transposing x to LHS. Now by doing such, 2x minus x give x, and what is left? 5. So that means value of x we got as 5. Now dear students, Saroj, we need to find what are the present age. So therefore, Saroj present age, which is equals to x, which is equals to 5. Saroj mother present age equals to 6x, and value of x is 5, that is 30 years. See, if Saroj is 5-year-old, his mother is 6 times of his present age, that is 30 years. Now let us see sum number 6. There is a narrow rectangular plot reserved for a school in Mahuli village. Now one rectangular plot is there in Mahuli village, which is reserved to construct a school. The length and the breadth of the plot are in the ratio of 11:4. Now dear student, here measure of its dimension not given. Now it is given in ratio form. Now it is given in ratio form. That is the length and breadth is given in ratio form. At the rate of rupees 100 per meter, it will cost the village panchayat rupees 75,000 to fence the plot. Now dear student, fencing this plot, fencing, you know, fencing means to put a fence around the plot. Such kind of fencing should be there. It cost village panchayat rupees 75,000 at the rate of rupees 100 per meter. What are the dimension of the plot? We need to find the value of the dimension of the plot. Now let us suppose length of rectangular plot B, its dimension, its dimension is given in ratio, that is 11:4. So we'll consider it as a 11x, and breadth of rectangular plot B 4x. We don't know what the actual value of this x. We need to find its measure, then we have to multiply it by 11 and 4. It is actually the length is 11 times x and breadth is 4 times x. We don't know the value of x, so we need to find the value of that variable. Now dear student, here at the rate of rupees 100 per meter, it costs the village panchayat rupees 75,000. Now the cost of fencing, that is, now cost of fencing is also given. Now before that, let us find the perimeter of this rectangular plot. Perimeter of rectangular plot. What is the formula of perimeter of rectangle? That is 2L plus B. Now here the length is, we considered it as an 11 times X, and the breadth is 4 times X. 11 plus 4 gives 15 times X, that is 30 times X. Now dear student, we got our value of perimeter, that is total perimeter is 30 times X. Still we don't know the actual dimension. Now the cost of fencing. cost of fencing at the rate of rupees 100. 100 should be multiplied by what? It should be multiplied with this length of this perimeter, which is 30 times x. So that means the cost of fencing will be 100 into 30 gives 3000 times x rupees. We don't know. It is 3000 whatever be the value of x. With that we have to multiply. Now dear student, but here the total cost of fencing is also given. That is, it will cost the village panchayat rupees 75,000. So what you will write? But the cost of fencing is rupees 75,000. Now what you just need to do is equalize both the value. Here also we got cost of fencing, that is this, and but the actual cost of fencing is also given. Just equalize the value so that we can get the value of this x. So therefore, that is 30,000 times x rupees equals to 75,000. By equalizing, as I told you, always try to eliminate the value whatever be x. So what you will do? 3000 times x should be divided by 3000. Whatever value I am taking toward my left, same value you have to take toward your right. 00 cancel and 33 cancel. X 0, all zeros cancel and 325 is up. That means I got my value of x. Now very simple now. Now it's very simple to find the value of dimension. So therefore, length, which is 11 times x, that is 11 times 25, just you need to multiply. 25 tens are 250. 25 tens are 250. And 25 elevens are, just add 25 to 250. So you will get the value of 11 times 25, that is 275 meter. Now dear student, breath, which is 4 times x, and value of x we got 25, that is 100 meter. This is how we got our value of both the dimensions, that is length and breadth. Let us do some number 7. Hassan buys 2 kind of cloth material for school uniform. Shirt material that cost him rupees 50 per meter and trouser material that cost him rupees 90 per meter. For every 3 meters of the shirt material, he buys 2 meters of trouser material. He sells the material at rupees 12% and 10% profit respectively. His total sale is rupees 36,600. How much trouser material did he buy? Now, dear student, in this particular question, the total length of shirt material and trouser material is not given. We have to find, whatever the question is there, how much trouser material did he buy? Only one condition is given, that for every 3 meters of shirt material, he used to buy 2 meters of trouser material. That means what? For every 3 meters of shirt material, he used to buy 2 meters of trouser. So only that hint is given. So let us start with that only. Let the length of shirt material be 3x meter. We don't know what is the total length. Therefore, the length of trouser material be 2x meter. Now, he used to brought the shirt material at rupees 50 per meter and trouser material at rupees 90 per meter. So let us find the cost price. Of first find out the cost price of shirt material. The cost for shirt material, cost of 1 meter into quantity. Quantity in the sense 3 meter per trouser, sorry, 3 meter per shirt. So what is the cost price of 1 meter? 50 rupees given. And quantity 3 meter per trouser. So that is 3x. When we multiply, so 150x. Now cost price for trouser, that is cost of 1 meter into quantity. Cost of 1 meter. So what is the cost of 1 meter? Per meter is 90 rupees. And he brought 2 meter per trouser. So 2x. So what is the cost? 180x. Now dear student, this is the cost price we found for shirt material, that is 150x, and trouser material, that is 180x. Now further, he used to sell the material at rupees 12% and 10% profit respectively. That means Hassan, first we will find the profit on shirt, that is 12%. Hassan sell shirt material at rupees 12% profit. The profit equals to 12% on CP, that is 12% means 12 by 100. What is the cost price of shirt material? 150x. 0 cut. 5 2s are 5 3s are 2 6s are 3 6s are 18. This is profit amount, profit on cost price while selling. Okay, so now this is profit on selling of shirt material. Now we have to find Hassan used to sell trouser material at rupees 10% profit. That means what? Profit equals to 10% of 10% on CP. That is 10%. What is the cost price of trouser? 180. X 0 0 0 0, but that is 18x is a profit on cost price by selling. Now his total sale is rupees 36,600. Total sale is also given. So now profit amount we found. Now let us find the selling price. So what we will do? Therefore, selling price of shirt material. Selling price is what? That is SP equals to CP plus profit. CP plus profit. Cost price of shirt material is 150x. And profit on cost price is 18x. So you will get 168x. And selling price of trouser material that is SP equals to CP plus profit, your old formula, this you did in your previous class. The cost price of trouser material is how much? 180x plus profit 18x. Profit 18x gives 198x. Now dear students, selling price also we found, that is selling price of shirt material is 168x and selling price of trouser material 198x. But here total sale amount is also given. So that only is the hint to find out the total length of trouser material. Let us rub it over here. Now as per the condition which is given, that is a total selling amount is given, that is 36,600 rupees. total selling amount means what? Selling price of shirt material plus selling price of trouser material, both including cost rupees 36,600. Now, dear student, selling price of shirt material we got 168x, and selling price of trouser material we got 198x, and total cost, that is total amount, he got 36,600. Let us add it. 168 plus 198, 366. Now we need to find the value of this unknown quantity, that is x. So 36,600 divided by 366 ones are, so that means the value of x is 100. Now dear student, for every 3 meter he used to buy 2 meter of trouser. So what will be the total length of the trouser we will get from this? So total length of trouser material equals to 2 times x, and value of x we got 100, that is 200 meters. That means what? He used to buy 200 meters of trouser. Suppose if they had asked you to find out the how much shirt material he bought, so just you need to multiply this 100 with this 3 times x. So he used to brought 300 meters of shirt. Let us start sum number 8. Half of a herd of a deer are grazing the field, and 3/4 of the remaining are playing nearby. The rest 9 are drinking water from the pond. Find the number of deer in the herd. Now dear student, in this particular question, number of deer in the herd not given, but the various conditions are given, and we have to find the number of deer in the herd. So let us assume the total number of a deer in the herd be x. So let us start with that only. Let total number of deer in the herd equals to x. Now start with the condition, half of a herd of the deer are grazing the field. So number of deer grazing in the field equals to, now dear student, if total number of a deer is x, so half of x is x by 2. X by 2 number of deer used to grazing in the field. Now, and 3/4 of the remaining are playing nearby. 3/4 of the remaining. We have to find now the remaining number of deer. So, if out of total number of deer, that is x, if half of the deer are grazing in the field, that is x by 2, so what is the total number of remaining deer? So, we have to find that. Therefore, remaining number of deer, that is, out of total number of deer, if half of the deer are grazing in the field, so no need to find the LCM, directly you do cross multiplication. 2 into x, 2x minus x gives x by 2 only. Now dear student, if these are the remaining number of deer, now we have to find the 3/4 of the remaining are playing nearby. We have to find the 3/4 of it. So how to find? Let us do it over here. 3/4 of deer given playing nearby. So you have to find 3/4 of x by 2. These are the remaining number of a deer. So 3/4 of x by 2 gives 3x by 8. After that, the rest 9 are drinking water. So write off number of deer drinking water equals to 9. Now dear student, we found all the value. Now finally, find the number of deer in the herd. So we had assumed that total number for deer in the herd is x. Let us take that hint only. Total number of deer in the herd equals to x. Out of total, half are grazing the field, 3/4 from the remaining, that is 8, used to play nearby, and 9 of the deer used to drink water. Now we need to find the LCM. Before that LCM, we have to transpose the value, our old method, try to bring x over here. Therefore, x by 2 as it is, 3x by 8 as it is. Now try to bring x, so positive x will become negative, and try to take this constant number toward your right, so it will become negative 9. So what statement you will write? Transposing. Dear student, you can do this transposition separately also. First you bring this x, then in next step you can take this 9 toward your right. Transposing x to LHS and 9 to RHS. By doing such, now here you need to find the LCM. Let us do it over here. Now LCM of 2 and 8 is 8 only. 2 and 8. 2 ones are 2 and 2 fours are 2 twos are and 2 ones are 2 twos are 4, 4 twos are 8. So write down, therefore LCM of 2 and 8 is 8. Now dear student, x by 2, to get 8 over here, 2 should be multiplied by 4. So you have to multiply x also with 4. Then 3x by 8 is there. To get 8 over here, 8 should be multiplied by 1. So 3x also multiplied by 1. Minus x is given. You have to consider 1 over here. To get 8 over here, 1 should be multiplied by 8. So you have to multiply 8 over here. Now, x into 4, 4x by 8, 3x by 8, minus 8x by 8 equals to 9. Now, 4x plus 3x minus 8x, common factor is 8, gives 7x minus 8x upon 8. 7 minus 8 gives negative 8. Now dear student, as I told you, as we have to find the value of this unknown quantity, that is x, it is a division form. So whatever value in division form, same value you have to take in multiple form. So whatever value in division form, you have to multiply. Whatever value you had multiplied in LHS, same value you have to multiply in RHS. So that 8 and 8 will get cancelled. That means negative x equals to negative 72 we got. Now dear student, negative 72 we got. The value of x cannot be negative. X cannot be negative. So what I will do? I will multiply negative 1 both this side. Why? Because if I multiply negative 1 on one side, so I have to multiply negative 1 on another side also. Why? To make it positive. So negative to negative positive, negative to negative positive. That means total 72 deers are there in the herd. So write down, number of deer in the herd is 72. Let us see some number 9. A grandfather is 10 times older than his granddaughter. He is also 54 years older than her. Find her present ages. Now dear student, here two conditions of her grandfather is given. Who is 10 times older than his granddaughter. And he is also 54 years older than her. Now here, we don't know the age of daughter, so let us assume it as a x. Let the present age of daughter be x here. We don't know her age. If daughter is x year old, so her grandfather age will be, he is 10 time older. 10 time means 10 time of x. 10x years. Now one more condition for grandfather is given, that is he is 54 year older than her. So grandfather further, grandfather is also 54 year older than her. So plus 54 means 54 year older than her means 54 years older than her daughter, that is who is x year old now. So present age of daughter plus 54. So present age of daughter is x, x plus 54. Now dear student, two ages of grandfather is given. Now we have to equalize both the value, then only we'll get the value of unknown quantity, that is x. So equalize both the value, that is one side 10x, as per the condition you can write down. And x equals to x plus 54. Very easy. Try to transfer this value toward your left. Will become negative. So write it over here. Transposing x to LHS. While doing 10x minus x gives 9x. Then let us do it over here. Eliminate this 9. So how to eliminate? 9x divided by what? Equals to 54. So to eliminate this 9, we have to divide this 9x by 9. Whatever value we are taking toward our left, same value you have to take in on your right. So therefore 9 and 9 will get cancelled. 9, 6. So that means value of x we got, that is 6. So that means the present age of daughter, that means the present age of daughter, which is equals to x, which is equals to 6 years, and present age of her grandfather, that is present age of her grandfather, who is 10 times his daughter, so 10 into 6, 60 years old. Now question number 10. Aman's age is 3 times his son's age. 10 years ago he was 5 times his son's age. Find their present age. Now dear student, here condition for Aman's age is given, who is 3 times his son's age. So let us suppose Aman's son age be x. Let present age of Aman's son be x year, because we don't know his present age. If Aman's son is x years old, so Aman will be 3 times, that is 3 x year old. So therefore Aman's present age is 3x year. Why 3x? Because he is 3 times his son. So if his son's present age is x year, so Aman's present age will be 3 times of x, that is 3x. Now 10 years ago he was 5 times his son is, 10 years ago. So we have to go 10 years ago. What was their age 10 years ago? So let us find 10 years ago their ages were. Let us find it. So if their present age is x, so Aman's son was x minus 10 years, because we are going back. And Aman's was, his present age is 3x, so 10 years ago he was 3x minus 10 years. Now the condition given 10 years ago, he was 5 times his son. Who was? Aman. So Aman's age 10 years ago, he was x 3x minus 10 year. So 10 years ago, so as per the condition, as per the condition, 10 years ago, Aman's father was 3x minus 10 years old. His father 10 years ago was 5 times, means you have to multiply 5 times of his son's age. So if Aman's father was 3x minus 10 year old 10 years ago, so his son was x minus 10 year old 10 years ago. So as per the condition, his father 10 years ago 5 times of his son's age. So his son is what? X minus 10. So make now solve it. 5 into x 5x, 5 into 10 50. Just if here it is mentioned that 10 years ago he was 5 times his son's present age. So here you have to take present age, that is x, but here not mentioned. So we have to take the age of Aman's son 10 years ago. Now dear student, let us do transposing. 3x, let us write it over here. 3x minus 10 equals to 5x minus 50. 5x minus 50. Now, transposition you know very well. What I will do? Try to take now. What I will do, on my right, I found that value of 5x is greater than 3x. So just do interchange. Whole part you bring it over here and whole part you take it over here. You are not transposing any value. You are just interchanging the part. Now it will be easy for you to transpose it. Now you can bring your 3x over here toward your left. So positive will become negative. And here already negative 10 is there. So try to take this for negative 50 toward your right. It will become positive 50. So here you have to write statement. Transposing 3x to LHS and negative 50 to RHS. Now it will be easy for you to do subtraction. 5x minus 3x gives 2x. Now 50 minus 10 gives 40. Now try to eliminate this value of 2. So I will divide this 2x by 2. So whatever value I am taking toward my left, the same value you have to take toward your right. So that 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So here I am getting 2 20s are 40. The value of x I got. That means what? The present age of Aman's son. Write down present age of Aman's son, who is x year old, equals to 20 years. Present age of Aman, who is 3 times his son age, the 3 time of x, that is 3 into 20 gives 60 years old.